was a fun time to play hockey.
Sometimes a team needs to be tested. They have to have their backs up against the wall.
The Blackhawks have dispatched the Detroit Red Wings!
We were excited. We were ready to go against L.A.
I don't think I've ever jumped that high.
Did that just really happen?
The Chicago Blackhawks have won the Stanley Cup!
Both fans and players alike wondered if the 2012-13 season ever would be played. Little did anyone know that it would be one for the ages.
Well, it was kind of a crazy year when you think about it, you know, going back to how the season started in late January.
It was wild, the first couple weeks getting back into it was sort of a shock to everybody's system. You know, I thought our guys did a pretty good job of staying ready throughout the lockout.
If there was any guy that benefited from the NHL taking a little bit extra time to get back on the ice, it was Hossa.
He had been knocked out in game number 3 of that series against the Phoenix Coyotes.
Let's just hope that Marian Hossa is going to be okay.
The fact that he was able to get that extra time to just keep skating, keep working, and make sure that he was 100% healthy, it showed right out of the gate. He was one of their top players from the start.
Hossa shoots, he scores! Marian Hossa! Third goal in 2 games!
Hossa and the Blackhawks got off to a fast start away from the confines of the United Center.
I looked at the schedule and I thought to myself, is this a misprint?
10 of our first 12 games were on the road.
Proved to be a blessing in disguise.
Got us all kind of familiar with each other again, and having some fun with the guys definitely is a good way to start the year off. It really helped as far as team bonding and kind of a camaraderie between the guys.
It's always great to see young guys come in and how excited they are to play in their first seasons.
Shazi's a little one of those guys that you know at the end of the night you played against him.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it was fantastic to be drafted by him and, you know, give me a shot in the minors and, you know, work my way up here, and thankful for everything they've done for me.
A shot, they score! Brendan Saad, his first National Hockey League goal!
He reminds me of myself a lot. He's a great kid.
To be able to get that opportunity and play well and to be able to stick.
It's great to see guys step in and have as much confidence as they did early on.
The confidence was contagious in the locker room as Chicago rattled off wins, chipping away at an NHL record.
We knew the start was going to be important, and yeah, we got a good start.
Hawks win! 3 in a row to start the season!
It was amazing. It was a fun time to play hockey.
They just seemed to find a confidence in every building they went into.
Back to Hossa! Hawks win! Hawks win!
Nobody foresaw anything close to that. We were hoping to get off to a good start, and it just kept going, going, going.
A franchise record! 6 straight wins to start a regular season!
Each game was another challenge trying to further and further that streak.
Big save by Emery! Oh, what a save by Crawford! Corey Crawford takes one away!
Both Corey Crawford, Ray Emery, tremendous.
We made mistakes. We always knew they were going to be back there bailing us out.
When I think back on some of those nights where they were on the cusp of losing but somehow found a way to win some of those games, I just shake my head.
I remember a game in Calgary where Ray Emery was just absolutely phenomenal.
Calgary was a different game. It was a back-to-back, and guys were kind of tired.
He sends Aguila on a breakaway over the hot line, down the slot, shoots! Emery with a butterfly save! What a save by Emery! Curtis Pancross can't buy a goal tonight.
Every time Ray Emery was in the net, I'd be watching Ray going, this guy is fantastic.
Great save there by Ray Emery.
What goaltending. Can't believe the chances that Calgary is getting.
Calgary Flames probably should have won that game about 9-1.
Knocked over the boards, but here's Hoosler for Foemeister. He scores! 34 seconds left in the third, and the Flames lead it 2-1.
We came back with, just seconds left.
There's a shot by Hossa, he scores! Oh, man. 2 seconds left in regulation!
And that's it. Overtime ends. We're going to a shootout.
Here's Kane down the slot. Deeks and shoots. He scores! with a backhand. Cervenka to the right wing circle, then to the slot, shoots. Emery knocks it wide with a glove.
Oh, my
Hawks
goodness.
Win! Those are not only congratulations, those are thanks he's getting from his teammates.
If not for Ray Emery putting forth the performance that he does, we're not even talking about a streak.
No one has beaten the Blackhawks in regulation so far this year.
Everyone focus on what Chicago is doing right now. Can they remain with that donut in the loss column?
27 of a possible 30 points so far for the Blackhawks. It's been a spectacular start.
It's everywhere. It definitely creeps in the locker room. And I don't think we have the team that it's going to bother too much.
There has never been a team go 17 straight to start a season without a loss in regulation.
We just kept playing. We never really focused much on what was being said outside the room.
All the cameras, all the attention from fans and media just made us play better.
And they extend their NHL record season opening point streak to 20 games.
We started getting in the late teens and the 20s. It was almost like these were all game sevens.
Fred Seabrook with a game-winning goal! They've done it again!
It's a playoff atmosphere every game.
In the first 24 games was unlike anything I could have ever imagined.
They just seem to keep building this momentum, this feeling of look at what we're doing. But yet they kind of balanced it with that thought of, okay, this can end at any time. If it does, it does.
You know you're not going to go the whole year undefeated, but going into Colorado, you know it's a tough place to play.
He centered it. Here's a shot. They score! Duchesne! Center score! Here's O'Reilly scores. It's 4-1 now. And the Hawks' undefeated streak is about to come to an end. It's 6-2.
Losing that game, it was a bit of a letdown, but it was kind of a sense of accomplishment.
We enjoyed the streak. It was a blast. Probably thought it was going to end a lot sooner than it did.
You know, every team was, you know, gunning for us because, you know, we were on that streak, and it got us ready for the playoffs.
The Blackhawks aspired to feed off their record-breaking momentum, and as they pushed toward the postseason, added what they hoped would be the final piece of a Stanley Cup puzzle.
Well, here's a shot. Hanzus scores! Welcome back to the Blackhawks, Michael Hanzus!
It was at that stage of his career, would love the chance to win a championship. When we found out that all of a sudden he was going to play in a second-line center role, it was like, wow, what a find for us.
He gave us that consistency we needed behind Jonathan Toews.
With the pieces in place, Chicago wanted to rebound from back-to-back early playoff exits.
When you look at the last two seasons in Chicago, we couldn't get out of the first round, losing to Phoenix and to Vancouver.
After what we accomplished, there were expectations from across the board, and we know that the pressure of not winning the last two rounds was in place.
The Blackhawks, they understand this, they've all said it. What's happened in the first 48 games doesn't mean anything.
Once that final buzzer sounds of the regular season, that's over. The new season starts.
Maybe a little bit of a bullseye on your back with how much success we had, but in the playoffs, it's a clean slate, and you got to come out to play.
The core group that lived through that great experience in 2010 was up to that group to guide these guys, knowing that, hey, we got to get back. Let's win a round here to get some momentum here.
Game one of the playoffs, it's always an exciting time. You know, we started at home. Our crowd was excited.
And it will be Minnesota renewing acquaintances with the Chicago Blackhawks in the playoffs.
They were excited to be back to the playoffs. That was a team that had some form of a rebirth this season with signing Zach Parise and Ryan Suter.
Coming into the postseason, the expectations in Minnesota were very high.
But before the series even started, the Wild suffered a setback.
A big story developed in the warm-up. Nicholas Backlund was supposed to start the game for the Minnesota Wild. He left early, looked to be injured. It does not appear he's going to start this game.
You're Josh Harding, and all of a sudden, Nicholas Backlund goes down in the warm-up. And Q, you've got to go in, you've got to play.
I've never seen that before.
As a guy that's supposed to score goals and try to score, I try not to worry about who's in net for the other team.
The Jennings Trophy, the President's Trophy, a record-setting start to the season. None of that makes any difference. It's all about the second season. And this opening round playoff game is underway. Cal Clutterbuck shooting, he scores! first shot on goal of the playoffs for the Minnesota Wild goes in. I don't know if nerves is the right word to say, but the Blackhawks out of sorts here in the first 15 minutes of this game.
The first game was kind of feeling it out, and we were kind of nervous.
It's the way the playoffs are going to be. Not a lot of room out there, and you got to scrap and claw for every piece of real estate on this rink.
In the second period, things began to turn around for Chicago. To King, cuts in over the wide line, fed the left circle, Hossa should be scores! Marian Hossa for the first Blackhawks goal of the playoffs, and a beautiful backhand feed from King. Oh! Back your top rope!
Chicago's pushing, and they're pushing hard.
This game is going to overtime.
Here we go, Regis. Here's Stolberg with a chance to win. Over the wild line, right wing, and then on front, he's in the scores! Hawks win!
Stolberg got some speed up the wall, and he posted up, and he found me in the slot, and I was lucky to put it home.
Brian Bickle in overtime!
Oh, wait, Rosie. Way to start the play with that flip. Nice soft play, Stoli.
I think that took a lot of the will away from the Minnesota Wild because they played a pretty good first game. And in game two, the Hawks just dictated the pace. They seemed to find their game, force the pace, force Minnesota to open it up. And Minnesota's not built that way.
Ease it up and fire. Stop by Bob. Rebound, score! That's where the Hawks get you. It's their depth. The fourth line here comes up big.
Brian Bickle was starting to come into his own, and Andrew Shaw, and they just kind of come at you in waves.
Game two was a game where we really started to find our groove and play better.
Backhand chance again, scores!
Yeah, baby! Yeah!
Scooping it off the wall and in sharp.
Welcome to the playoffs, kid. Comes back to Kane, moves it to the backhand, turns it up the sharp for an open net goal!
Showtime! That's hockey, baby! Woo!
That's hockey, baby!
That's hockey!
Set up by the magic of Kane. Chicago Blackhawks were absolutely magnificent in this game tonight.
Work hard all season to get that home ice advantage, and to be able to start off the series 2-0, that's also a huge advantage.
You gotta get those first two games, put the other team on their heels, and you know, just kind of go and attack them there.
Energized by the hometown crowd, Minnesota forced overtime once again.
Probably the best thing for us that we lost that game.
To see them, you know, get the OT winner, it didn't faze us, and it just made us push harder.
Game four of this Western Conference quarterfinal series, Chicago with a 2-1 series lead. Picked off by Hossa, keeps it in back and front, scores! 1-0 Chicago.
Sharp takes the puck away over the wild line, he shoots, he scores! Patrick Sharp with his second goal of the night! Bickle shot, scores! Oh my, what a goal by Bickle! That goal has taken all the wind out of this building.
We slowly got closer to playing that playoff style hockey that we needed to play.
Put it to the doorstep, Spurs, and he shoots. Turned wide by Crawford. Scramble in the crease.
Away, Crow.
Back in front, Poison shot. Here's Pamino with a shot right up.
Magnificent job in goal by the Blackhawks goaltender.
The horn sounds, and the Hawks go up 3-1 on the Minnesota Wild. A shutout for Corey Crawford. The Chicago Blackhawks have Minnesota down 3-1. They can capture this series with a victory tonight on home ice.
With an opportunity to win its first series in 3 years, Chicago turned to a veteran.
Now, Hossa is a complete player. Being able to play with him, you see really how good he is.
Hossa is one of those guys that got us going offensively. And you want to talk about guys that got off to hot starts in the playoffs.
Hayes recovers left circle, gave it to Hossa, should he score?
Team. They are so skilled and so good.
1-0, this crowd now into it.
He's a clutch player, you know, he plays big in those big games. You know, he knows what it takes to win.
We saw the Marian Hossa of old in that series.
These people are on their feet here at the United Center.
Hawks win! Hawks win, and for the first time since they won the Stanley Cup in 2010, the Chicago Blackhawks have won a playoff series. They beat the Wild here tonight by the score of 5-1 and win this playoff series 4-1.
Original six matchup, Chicago-Detroit.
Yeah, they don't like each other.
The hockey between these two is just so fun to watch.
When these two teams meet in the playoff, you're gonna have a tough series.
Come on, Red, come on, boys.
That's a rivalry that's been reborn in the last 5-6 years.
You looked at that matchup realizing that Detroit's going east next season.
Could be the last time you see those two teams match up.
It didn't take long for the Blackhawks and Red Wings to renew their historic rivalry.
Smith popped it up. Here's a shot for Ozzie. Scores! Power play goal! And the Hawks draw first blood of this playoff series.
Moves and shoots one. This block down. Follows through. He scores!
Damian Bruder's goal would be Detroit's lone tally. As Chicago dominated game one.
Rifled on out to Oduya. Scores!
Carcillo pokes it out in front. Here's a shot by Curry. Scores! Great work by Daniel Carcillo.
Onside is sharp. Net empty. Scores!
The Blackhawks are going to win game number one.
Game one, the Blackhawks won 4-1, and they felt like they had control of the series and that they were going to be able to win game two the same way.
Detroit, they're ready for a better game today.
Here we go, boys. Here we go. Here we go.
The Red Wings came out, and they played the best hockey I think I've seen them play all year long.
I think we just got away from our game.
Every time our forward gets it, they don't even back check.
Zetterberg, fed one in front. Score! And it is 2-1 in favor of Detroit.
Red Wings looking sharper and sharper.
The Red Wings were well-rested. They were 2 days off in between games one and game two. That suited them extremely well.
Zetterberg drops it off. Filppula carries on. Crossover. Score! Filppula!
Great effort by the Red Wings today.
The Blackhawks didn't have a whole heck of a lot that game. Detroit did a really good job of shutting down the Hawks.
With the series tied, the Blackhawks headed to Detroit.
I think they played really well in games three and four and probably deserved a little bit of better fate.
Nyquist brings it in, crosses over, scores!
What a goal!
And this game is in the books for Detroit, 3-1.
I think game four was maybe that toughest game where we were just pushing ourselves as hard as we could.
What a chance that was for Kane. Sharp on side, shooting and a save by Howard.
Well, it was a shot from the outside, a rebound, a two-on-one opportunity. He was making them every way he could.
Nice save by Howard. Fires in front. What a save by Howard on Boland.
Frustration setting in.
You know, we weren't playing physical. We were using our speed, and I think we were taking a lot of, you know, unnecessary penalties.
Another penalty coming to Chicago.
Pugliacco feeding it. Kinder with a shot. He scores!
After that game four, we really need to find a way to regroup and find that belief and bring that out and put it back on the ice.
Chicago won the first game, made it look pretty easy. Now they've lost the next three. There's pressure on everybody tonight.
Jamal Mayer's talked to us, gave us a little speech on how it doesn't come around that often.
He didn't touch the ice much in the playoffs, but you could feel the emotion in his voice when we talked about how tough it was.
You know, sometimes a team needs to be tested. They have to have their backs up against the wall.
He reminded us that this was an opportunity that we couldn't waste. Even though we were down 3-1, the series was long from being over.
And Chicago finally get a goal. Pretty good start now for Chicago, you'd have to say.
They came out and got momentum in game five.
Back to Keith, one-timer, they score! It's Andrew Shaw in front of the net!
Jonathan Toews got on the scoreboard with a power play goal.
First playoff goal for Johnny Toews! Off the net, rebound, scores! Andrew Shaw with a second goal of the game on a wraparound!
And Chicago stays alive.
And this series is going to a sixth game.
It was big for our group to get over that hurdle and start rolling again.
Tonight, the Red Wings will try to deliver one more knockout punch.
The excitement level of our team right off the bat was in the right place.
Line, reverse, offside!
The commitment to doing the right things and finding a way.
To Toews in low, walks it to the net, loose puck and scramble, he scores! A power play goal! And the Hawks take the lead in Detroit, 1-0.
Detroit even the score late in the first period. And they got a lucky break midway through the second.
Anderson with a shot. Score!
Corey Crawford trying to find this into his glove, and it goes right by him.
Pretty rough goal on my part.
Playing in the National Hockey League, especially in the playoff stage, it tests you. It tests your resolve.
The old Corey Crawford would have been affected by that Anderson goal that probably would have gotten into his head and affected his play for the rest of that game. But this version of Corey Crawford knows how to put that goal behind him.
One thing about Corey Crawford this year is that the Chicago Blackhawks have talked extensively how he's a more focused goaltender.
I don't like to use the term man up too often, but that's exactly what he did.
We all knew he was a great goaltender. It was only a matter of time before he showed it to everyone else.
Just keep playing our game and get through it. And, you know, everyone was able to bounce back.
I've got to tell you, I'm impressed with Chicago. The second period was really not a good period for them, but they have come back and showed tremendous resiliency.
And what have we coming up here? A penalty shot!
I just tried to, you know, took a deep breath and don't think too much.
Cruises in over the red wing line, down the slot, Deeks, and Chichi scores! And he gives the Hawks a 4-2 lead over the Red Wings.
I've got to tell you, I'm impressed with Chicago. They have come back and showed tremendous resiliency.
Hawks win, and they tie this playoff series at 3 games apiece, and we'll head back to the Windy City for game number 7.
What a roller coaster of emotions. It's been a tough, hard-fought series for Chicago. They're down 3-1. They get it back to game 7.
When you win those 2 games and you force a game 7, there's no doubt in your mind that you have the momentum and you're going to find a way to win.
Game 7s are the stuff of greatest glories or long nightmares.
It was an up-and-down game.
Nick Leddy able to step to center and take his own pass. And a shot save, and a rebound, and another save.
There were a bunch of chances either way, and it could have gone either way, to be honest.
Save by Crawford!
Hey, go, go, go!
That's fine, boys. It's going here.
What was it, sir?
Game 7 is one of the games I'll always remember for the rest of my career.
Let's go get an SOG.
Here's Sharp picking a pass from Hanzus on the red wing line. Holson front back to Sharp, and she scores! What a play!
Is just one goal scored by Patrick Sharp.
Down behind the net, Bruner put it out in front of Hamilton. He shoots, save Crawford.
We were kind of on our heels, playing too defensive, and they had a lot of chances.
When ahead comes Nyquist. Nyquist finesse it across, they score! Zetterberg! And the game is tied!
I knew Game 7 wasn't going to be an easy game for the Blackhawks. I thought the Blackhawks could win that game in regulation. They had a late push.
Zetterberg now gains center ice, but he's knocked down by the man, Child Saad, who moves it to Shaw with the wing line, right circle, to the slot, Johansson closes for score! With 1:47 left in the third, it's 2-1 Hawks in game 7!
They're going to wave this off. They're going to say that this play was blown dead.
Nick Kalmarsson scores a goal right as they're calling a penalty, and the goal is disallowed.
Behind the play, Kyle Quincy hits Brandon Saad. Saad punched up from the ice. That's where the call came. Nobody really knew that the goal had been disallowed until a couple of seconds after the euphoria settled a little bit. Stephen Walkham, he made what I felt was a real gutsy call. It went against the Blackhawks, for sure, but it was a gutsy call. They think they have it won. Crowd's going crazy, bench is going crazy, and then it's blown off because of a penalty call.
It was an incredible emotional swing. Where are we going to go from here? Are we going to be a team that was emotionally deflated for what happened by not having that goal allowed? Or are we going to have a team that's going to rally?
And we will need overtime.
We've had to find a way to regroup and get over it.
You know, we go in the dressing room and we calm down pretty quick and realize that we still had an overtime to play.
Oh, and a big hit by Bowen on Nyquist front of the penalty boxes. Seabrook goes to the red wing box and he scores! Hawks win!
We like to call Brent Seabrook the overtime specialist.
The Blackhawks have dispatched the Detroit Red Wings on a Seabrook overtime goal!
That time of game, you just get him the puck and he does the rest. Pretty special thing to win in overtime in Game 7 against an old-time rival like the Detroit Red Wings.
Serious, Patty. Good luck.
Tell the Cup champs the Blackhawks are waiting for them. The Hawks are headed back to the Western Conference Finals.
You're always the Stanley Cup champ until you lose, and it's hard to knock off that defending champion. And the LA Kings will make you earn it.
They're a physical team as far as finishing their checks on the aggressive forecheck that they like to have. They defend well, and they've got maybe the best goaltender in the game in Jonathan Quick.
A great goalie, one of the best goalies in the league, and tough to score, and he works so hard, and he's never out of it.
We carried a lot of momentum and a lot of confidence out of that series against Detroit. That belief was finally there, that we'd played some great hockey, and we found a way to get out of a very difficult situation against Detroit. So we were excited. We were ready to go against LA.
All set for game number one. And Kopitar faces off against Jonathan Toews. A new look for the Hawks as Toews centers Brian Bickle along with Marian Hossa. Bickle tees it up. Quick makes the stop, juggles it.
Here's a chance for Toews. Centers it down. Cross one-timer sharp. Knocked out, rebound.
Despite Chicago's early offensive onslaught, the Kings struck first.
And Fox score! This bounces off a skate in front of Crawford.
And the Kings have seized the lead.
The Blackhawks outshot the Kings 19-2 in the first, but still hadn't beaten Quick.
We know we had to be better in front of the net.
Go right into him! Right into him!
So
William
moves in and hammers a shot. Save, rebound, score!
Yeah, we knew we had to get to Quick. So we had to get bodies in front of him, and we had to get him moving side to side, and we did.
Runs it to the left point to Keith. Winds up, fire, score! In front of the King, man, I believe Marian Hossa got a tip on it. And for the first time in the series, the Blackhawks lead the defending Stanley Cup champions. Richard on the backhand, fakes, tries to come out on the near side. Oh, and he is drilled by Boland.
And so we're set for game number two in the Western Conference Final on this second night of back-to-backs. And major changes for the LA Kings, most notably the fact that Mike Richards will not play, Ray.
You know, we knew they were going to come out, you know, twice as hard as they did in the first game. And it just shows we pushed each other and, you know, we kept competing and sticking to it.
Run it around on outside on the left wing board. The Stalber going to slot. They should just go!
Drops it back to Seabrook in fire score! Seabrook 2-0 Chicago!
We were able to score a couple goals on him, get some nice bounces.
To the line, Sharp fires a shot, stop the victory, let's score!
Thanks to Gregory, put it in his own net.
Did he did it?
Yeah.
Was it you?
Well, I touched it, but he just put it in his own net afterwards.
Right. Hopefully, we get it.
Four goals in 30 minutes. And Michael Hanzus ends the night for Jonathan Quick.
With Quick watching, the goaltender at the other end of the ice was defending much more than just his net.
Oh, the players go down. Wow. Toews was knocked down by Fraser. Oh. Clifford was there. Look at Crawford coming to help his captain because Jonathan Toews was tied up with Kyle Clifford, who's a tough guy.
You know, it's not too often you see your goaltender having to step in and help you out.
Well, I held on pretty tight there, so he's a pretty tough guy, so I didn't want to let go.
And the Blackhawks now have a two-game-to-none lead over the defense.
Chase Lawson, Griffin, Larry.
Wasn't going to be easy. We knew he was going to rebound off and come in and play one of his best games of his career. Because that's what goalies do, you know. Elite goalies like that are going to come in and, you know, better themselves the next game after games like that.
What a stop by Quick! I believe he made the save there.
We said we're going to just push back right away, but we didn't. We kind of waited, and we weren't skating. We didn't initiate. We just kind of waited it out.
Outworked and outplayed by the defending champs, frustration set in.
Oh, Duncan Keith just turned around, one-handed slash, Jeff Carter right in the mouth.
It was an accident. Didn't mean to get him where I got him. It is what it is now.
The Chicago Blackhawks will live without Duncan Keith tonight, who will serve a one-game suspension.
When you are missing one of the best defensemen in the entire National Hockey League, that's not in a lineup. Guys have to really step up.
It's a total team effort to replace a guy who plays as well for them as Duncan Keith does.
We felt confident, even though losing Dunks was a huge part. We battled it out, and we knew we were going to be all right.
Moves it to Bickle over the King line. High slot. Shoots. He scores! Brian Bickle with his third goal in three games against the Kings in this playoffs.
Bixie's a big boy. He's a power forward.
When you're hot, you're hot.
Our goal is to get inside the box and just take his eyes away and just get, second, third opportunities. And, I think I did it well, and I think it sparked the team.
Jalberson with a shot. Tipped. Score! It was tipped in front of Quick, and the persistence of the Blackhawks pays off. With a minute 39 remaining in the second, they have tied this game at two. It'll be Kane's first of the series and third of the playoffs.
That's a great shot.
Breaks in over the King line, gave it to Hossa. He scores! Marian Hossa from the top of the right circle. And for the first time since coming to L.A., the Blackhawks lead the Kings. It's 3-2.
Very big win for the Chicago Blackhawks. Going home to take a 3-1 lead with them.
Game 5 marked the return of two stars to the series.
Mike Richards is going to return, although he won't play on that second line with Jeff Carter.
Duncan Keith returns.
He was ready to play when he came back. You kind of saw it in his eyes a little bit. He wanted to make a difference and had that little bit extra spark.
Once again, it's Keith coming on.
Scores! Back in the lineup after a one-game suspension. Duncan Keith hammered it right through the five hole on Quick. Back to Keith, enters center ice. Shot a pass ahead for Bickle that misses. He slides down to get it. A loose puck in front. Tays pokes it on goal. Save. Rebound. Here's Kane. Shoots the score!
The Kings, facing elimination, would not give up, evening the game at two in the third.
I was in a situation where I wanted to get the puck and make some plays and try to help the team out as best as I could.
Evan Potts goal!
Gainer, he steps up in big moments, and, you know, when he gets going, it's tough to stop him.
I think I scored with, 3.5 minutes left to make it 3-2, so you're feeling pretty good. You got two goals and hopefully the game winner.
Here's the drop of the puck. The Kings get it. Voinoff, right point. To Kopitar, right half board. Fires. They score! Mike Richards in front of the Hawk. Net deflects it past Crawford. With 9 seconds left, the Kings have tied the score at 3.
And this game 5 is headed to overtime. They needed that rest, put it that way, after the first 20-minute overtime period. Now, let's go to a fresh one, and let's see what happens in this baby.
I think we were just coming down in overtime. Kaner and I were looking at each other on the bench saying that we had to do something. Get the puck from Voinoff and get it to Taser. And it's 2-on-1, and put it right on a stick, and he made no mistakes. And put it right in my wheelhouse to just get it one-timer. I tried to get it off as quick as I could.
Duncan Keith and the Blackhawks moving on to face
the Boston Bruins in the 2013 Stanley Cup Final.
All right, so be excited. Congratulations. All right, we just keep getting better and better and better. All right, great job. Let's go.
I knew before Game 5 of the LA series that if the Blackhawks were able to beat the Kings, their reward was to be able to play the Boston Bruins, who were the LA Kings with a little more offensive potential.
I look at the Bruins and the Kings as very similar because they are sturdy teams, built strong in all the right areas.
Rebound loose at the top of the crease. Rashad score! Bergeron! Bergeron! In game 7, and the Bruins win the series!
You have two great hockey markets with two original six teams, two recent winners of the Stanley Cup. We couldn't ask for anything better than that, to have the Bruins and the Blackhawks fighting for the Stanley Cup.
When I think of the Blackhawks, I think of Stan Mikita and Bobby Hull. I think of Bobby Orr and Phil Esposito for the Boston Bruins. We're not talking about teams that have gone back 20 or 30 years. We're talking about teams that have gone back almost 100.
Inla, Rishon, Blotzheim, Ryan, and the Bruins win! They sweep the Pittsburgh Penguins to return to the Stanley Cup Finals!
They're a tough team, and they won a Stanley Cup a couple years ago for a reason. We knew that both teams deserved to be in the finals, and that it was going to be a great series.
Good face-off, team. Let's make sure when we go through with wingers on the draw, follow the puck, don't go to the rug. Look for that puck.
Chicago Blackhawks, founded in 1926, 2 years after the Boston Bruins, meeting for the first time in the Stanley Cup Final.
And the Stanley Cup Final is underway.
In come the Blackhawks, who saw Saad stopped by Tuukka Rask.
Behind the Hawk net, bounces down to Bergeron. Put it out in front. Seabrook whacks it away, but look out. Here's Marchand with a shot. Bluff save made by Corey Crawford. Marchand thought he had a goal, and Crawford so far has made the save of the finals with the glove.
Great start here between Boston and Chicago.
With the shortened season, we didn't see them at all in the regular season, so we didn't quite know how we were going to match up.
Krejci on the right wing. Goes in after behind the net. Jarmelson took a run at him. Krejci avoided it. Lucic score!
I don't know if those nerves are what, but they got up on us.
Milan Lucic from the slot, set up by Horton. And the Bruins lead it 1-0 in the first.
They got our attention right off the bat, especially their top line. We were trying to find different ways to figure out who was going to play against them because we hadn't seen a line that dominating all year.
Picked up by Krejci. Krejci cutting it back to Lucic with a shot. He scores!
Milan Lucic's second goal of this game has made it 2-0.
Hey, great job, you guys.
They're a great team. We knew that. We kind of just looked at their game and tried to, you know, counterattack them.
Hoss able to dance by. Got it to Saad.
Are right back in it.
Even if we're down two goals, we know we can score goals. And that's what our mindset was right there.
Keep getting to the net here. Keep getting to the net here. Come on.
Heaves to the front of the net. What a save by Rask. Dave Bolin with a shot. Rebound! And Brandon Saad was there, but he couldn't get the rebound.
2 seconds, one. The horn sounds, ending play in period number two.
We knew we were in for a tough series. They're a great opponent, and it wasn't going to be easy.
Chara tipped up, and here comes the Boston Bruins' first power play of the night.
Well, the Bruins with a great chance here to restore a two-goal lead. They're up 2-1 in the slot, Sig, and now Bergeron a drive, and he scores! Yeah! Patrice Bergeron rips in behind Corey Crawford. It's a power play goal.
Had a lot more patience with the puck than we anticipated. They had a lot more playmaking ability than we anticipated.
Boston in control of the game, up 3-1.
We had a bit of a slow start in that game and found our way slowly back into it in the third period.
Let's take it to him here, boys. Krug shot the puck to center ice, picked off by Shaw over the Bruin line, down the right wing, fed it across, ball, and should he score? Steve Bullen!
It was a turning point in the momentum swing for us getting back in that game. Shazzy gave me a nice pass. I just had to put it in the back of the net.
He
He's got a lot of passion, you know, brings a lot of spark. He's got a lot of energy. He does whatever it takes to make this team win.
Let's go!
Being down by 2 goals in the game, you know, it just shows, you know, we weren't willing to go away easily.
Go, boys, push, push!
3-2 Boston, 8.5 to go.
Frolik gave it to Kruger to the line. Oduya winds and fires and scores! The Hawks have tied the game at 3! 3-3 the score with 7:46 left in the third, and the Madhouse is rocking again!
A break for the Blackhawks. The shot off the left skate of Andrew Ferris in behind Tuukka Rask. A fortunate bounce.
Kind of a lucky play. That shot a little bit wider, and it went off his skate and went in. It was a pretty good feeling.
Dying seconds of the third period, and that'll do it. Game one of the Stanley Cup Final is tied 3-3 through three.
Fell behind by a couple goals, and it's not easy to come back against that team. So to be able to get that game to overtime, you know, that was a challenge in and of itself.
Well, we're about to find out if this will end quickly or will it be a marathon night. Overtime underway in Chicago.
Here's Paille to a loose puck at center ice over the Hawk line, left wing from the slot. Thornton moves in. Scrambling save is made by Corey Crawford.
Corey Crawford was tested I don't know how many times by the Bruins with quality chances and came up with some magnificent saves.
Here come the Bruins, 2-on-1. Krejci over the Hawk line, down the right wing. He hits the trailer, Sagan with a drive. Saved by Crawford. The rebound is swept out of there.
That was a crazy game. I don't know how else to describe it. It was back and forth, back and forth.
Kane curling through the high slot. Kane all the way to the top of the left circle. Guns it toward the net, and a close save is made by Rask.
He's smart!
As it turned out, the game went on and on and on and on.
5.5 minutes into double OT.
Look at this, here's Sagan breaking on in. Save made by Crawford. Now that Asher Hauser's behind the net, put it in front for Kane, and he can't wrap it in on goal. Yeah. Oh. 5:25 remaining in the second overtime. Paille to the net, save. Rebound chance here for Krug, and a save made by Crawford.
Never been in a game like that before. Everybody was exhausted. We were trying to eat stuff between periods to give us energy.
This is now officially the longest game of the 2013 playoffs.
The fatigue definitely settles in, and the trust, you know, that you can do it, it's something that keeps you going.
A penalty here on Chicago upcoming. Many men on the
Too
ice.
Many men on the ice.
15 to get one. Sagan left point back to Chara, sends it to the net. The hit post.
Anything can pretty much happen. That's one bounce away, and you know, once again, it was a pretty lucky play.
Man, the Bruins came ever so close. We had the triple overtime.
This is probably one of the most tiring games I've ever played in.
Nearing the halfway point of the third overtime. Now here's Krejci, feeds it now high slot, Sagan, down to Dogovic, backhand, he fanned on it! Yeah! What a chance for Dogovic!
Everything right except the finish.
Nice try, Dog!
As it turned out, Andrew Shaw, right place, right time.
To the right wing corner, off Shaw's stick, hit by Seidenberg. Seidenberg is pummeled by Bickle with a body check. Rosal off for the right point, fires, he scores!
I got the puck and I just shot the puck at the net, and Bolli and Shawzy were in front of the net, and I deflected off both of these guys and it went in, so it was kind of lucky goal, but it was a great feeling to have the game over.
The Blackhawks lead the Boston Bruins 1-0 in the Stanley Cup Final!
It's huge when you go the distance like that and you find a way to win the game. I think when you go to three overtimes, when that happens in game one, you get the feeling it's going to be a long series.
I asked Joel Quenneville, you know, you didn't play Boston during the course of the regular season. When you played that first game when it was over, was there anything that surprised you about Boston? He said, yes, I didn't know they were this good.
Game one, to get that win was huge for us, but rolling into game two, it's a clean slate, really. You got to win four games, so they're not going to sit down, especially after a loss.
It feels like we've been playing for weeks against these guys. You know, and we expect a tough series. We knew that coming into it. It's going to be a fun game tonight.
Let's go, White, folks, on the start, boys. Let's go.
You know, the start was going to be important, and I think the first period there was one of our best.
Hey, to the wheel, go, Lex.
Letty shoots. By Rask.
Ahead now it's Letty. Letty tucked one in front. Oh, and it wouldn't go through Rask.
What a play by Sharp out of midair.
We had a great start, I remember, to the game. I think it was, you know, we had 19, 20 shots in the first period.
Another save, Rask. Scramble there. Kelp comes. It came into the crease and was swatted away. Another try. They score! It is Sharp, and it is 1-0 after a flurry of shots.
We were up 1-0, but we easily could have had a few more goal lead.
Taves, wraparound try. Rask is down along the goal line. Where's the puck? No indication that it's in, but you know there will be video review as to where this puck ended up.
It was definitely in right along the side. The question is, was McCauley blowing his whistle?
After reviewing the play, the call on the ice stands, no goal.
That is a potential game-changing decision just made by Wes McCauley.
Having the 1-0 lead after the first period, it was almost like we were in a great spot, and it was almost like, you know, it would have been nice to get the two because we definitely had great chances and great opportunities. But only being up 1-0, you knew that they're going to get their chances and their turn.
It's probably time for Claude Julien to change up his lines, to jumpstart his team. And he did just that. To begin the second, Julien reconstructed his checking line with three players all eager to contribute.
Kelly without a point, Paille not being able to score, Sagan with just one. This is a line that you really need to find some offense from.
Taken by Paille, dances free out front, trying to put one, they score!
Woo! It's total team play for the Bruins there. They needed a surge.
And the Bruins tie it late in the second period.
It's good job. Oh,
great job, buddy.
That's good job, buddy.
See what that does to the confidence and play of this Boston team.
After that, you know, they just got better and better as the game went on.
That's the magic of Stanley Cup final hockey. I mean, the games can change so quickly.
They start skating and we kind of start kind of watching more, stop skating.
Boston shut down the Blackhawks' potent offense and dominated the third, sending the game once again into sudden death.
Here we go again.
Hopefully it's gonna end soon, and hopefully we're on the right side of it.
Fire red, Buck D, let's go. Shot, lots of them. And this quick here.
In the third, they were starting to come on strong, and then in overtime, I thought they dominated that game.
That's it.
Here comes Marchand rolling back in. Got it onto Yager. No, it rang off the pipe.
Stay ready, guys.
Really, how the game changed, and Chicago just hasn't been able to get anything at the net since the first period, and they've been outplayed.
Turned over by the Hawks. Now it comes to Paye.
Seemed to turn a little bit. Talk about kind of the flow of the game.
They stole that one from us.
That's the start we were looking for. I just started letting them do whatever they wanted to, and we gave them chance after chance.
Something that we'll definitely take a look at and hope to correct in Boston, but we're going to have to go there and, you know, play our best games in games three and four.
As the series shifted to Boston, the Blackhawks entered enemy territory, where the Bruins had won six straight home games.
Let's go, Bruins! Go Bruins!
Chicago was dealt a surprising blow shortly before the opening faceoff.
We've just been handed a note here that Marian Hossa is a late scratch for the Chicago Blackhawks.
Whenever you take Hossa out of the lineup, he's a player that does so much for you on and off the ice that it was a big loss.
Now down to center ice we go. The drop of the puck in game three of the Cup Finals is underway.
I thought we started well game three. Had nothing to show for it as well.
Skid hard.
I thought we didn't give up a ton early in the second. When they did score, they got a huge boost.
Score! It is Paye! 1-0.
Let's get another one here.
This is Boston's first 5-on-3 in the playoffs.
5-on-3 that will last 11 seconds, but with a good face-off team, that could be an eternity for Chicago.
Down low, Jágr, first man back. Jágr centered it. Bergeron scores! Patrice Bergeron to make it 2-0!
To not even generate any offense and score zero goals was disappointing, but they played well that game and deserved the win.
And Tuukka Rask just put an exclamation mark on his third shutout of the playoffs.
We didn't play our best hockey, and we knew that. They're up 2-1, and we had a steal game in Boston. They did it to us in Chicago, and we had to refocus and regroup and take a good look in the mirror and come to play for game four.
We knew game four is going to be really important for us, so going into that game, we said this is our game seven. We need to win here.
And there's number 81 on the Chicago bench. That's good news for them, Marian Hossa.
Ah!
It's the green light time if you're Joel Quenneville. Send them. Crawford might have some odd man rushes to stop at the other end, but it's time to take those chances and break through against Tuukka Rask.
I like Chicago's start. They've got some zip in their game.
And Brandon Saad steals it away. Racing over the blue line the other way. We put it in front. Michael Hutzus, he should be scored! A shorthanded goal for the Hawks! And the Blackhawks have two first here in Boston in game number four.
What's up, boys? How are you, Zeus?
Good job, buddy. What a play.
We came out flying, and you could see that game with the pace, and it really opened up.
Go.
So again, Chicago in the faceoff circle has been more efficient here in the first. Good keep in by Ferentz, but now it's picked up by Peverly. His shot's good. Couple of chances to get it out for Chicago. They fail. Rich Peverly on the power play.
Any time? It's kind of a bad trade-off. Huh? Yeah, you're doing good, too.
I'd like to see the Pistons really start to pump, and that means Taves and Kane and Hossa, they've been almost invisible for most of this series. I can't imagine the Hawks winning the series unless these guys show up in force at some point.
Jonathan Taves drove wide through the puck off the boards. Throws the ball.
In front, that's by Tuukka Rask, and the Chicago Blackhawks have the lead again, 2-1.
Settle down, boys. We're placing it there. All right. Should have kept your mouth shut.
And Patrick Kane, he's with him, skating up the middle. Kane holds up, feeds Bickle, can't get to the net, but he got the puck to Kane. Rolls the ball again, another shot, this time blocked in front. Bickle gets the puck. Loose puck.
That's how we play. Wake up the beast. Wake up the beast, baby.
Coach Julian's inspiring words not only changed his team's momentum, but also the complexion of the game.
We knew we can play that game, too. We can score goals.
Frolik with speed, cutting it. Frolik sends it across. Oh, what a save, rebound, score! Chicago has regained the two-goal advantage.
It was just like one of those nights where nobody wanted to lose, everybody wanted to win, and it felt like full steam ahead type of game where you're not looking back, just keep going.
Char walking to the high slot with a wrist shot. Save Crawford off the left shoulder, comes right off the back of the net, and Bergeron scores!
It felt like every time we got the lead, they scored on us.
But Bergeron, a shot, score! Patrice Bergeron has tied this
game's a must-win in the playoffs, but you could really point to that game as one that we wanted to win.
Lucic fed that game it up to Kane.
Come on! Oh, penalty shot!
There'll be a penalty coming up.
Play your strong side. You've got to play your...
Are we trying to low?
He's back door. I'm back door.
Yeah.
Sharp, Kane,
yeah.
Rosie, Hawks.
That's right.
Me and Kane are going to get to the net when it's up here. Try and get to the middle.
In 32 seconds, we have a 5-on-3 for about 20 seconds. So if we're patient, if we have to be patient, be patient. Hey, I'm telling Taser to go right to the net. 32 seconds, we got a 5-on-3. You go right to the net. Right to the net. Hey, be patient. Don't force anything.
Patrick Sharp fans it out. 2 seconds and one, and now the first penalty is over. Hossa gives on to Keith. Hossa shot save. Rebound. Score! Sharp! And it's 5-4.
Get away, boys! Get away, PP! Huge goal.
Let's go.
Huge goal.
You feel like you're in a good position at 3-1, then 4-2, then you score a goal on a power play, which we didn't do too much of in the playoffs, and you're feeling good at 5-4.
We're down to 7:50 left now. Boychuk straight away, open, drive, score! Johnny Boychuk! Lopsided end! It's 5-5!
I thought that was the game where we kind of broke through in the series. Battled harder. There was more trash talk. There was more physical battles.
You tired? Your centerman is. I got hard.
I guess it looked like every game was gonna go up to you. It was so close.
And now Ferentz will guide it over to the corner to Marchand. And time elapses here in regulation. For the third time in 4 games of the Stanley Cup Final, we're going to overtime.
We knew we had to steal one on the road because, again, going down 3-1 is not an ideal situation to be in. We went there before, and you know, it was tough coming out of it.
Go!
You get in that overtime situation again, it's like, you know, anything can happen.
You just got to leave it out on the line.
Bixby shot it, bounced off somebody's skate and on my stick, and I just tried to shoot it and get it on net.
Circle fires, he scores! Hawks win! Hawks win! Seabrook with a bomb!
That was a huge game for us and a huge effort by the guys.
Woo!
You know, we had a lot of energy, a lot of momentum going home.
They say during the anthem, it reaches 122 decibels in here. Now a jet engine roars at 140, so it's loud. Game number 5 in Chicago. And what we have now is a best of 3 series for the Stanley Cup.
Blackhawk fans, this should be good. Game 5 began with both teams playing cautiously.
Will!
Heavyweights out, they're just feeling themselves out in the early rounds.
Nobody wants to make a mistake.
And it wasn't until later in the period that an overzealous forecheck led to a scoring chance.
Let it go to Hossa, over the Bruin line, stopping at the right point. Try the slot, here's Anzus over to Sharp. He shoots, oh, what a save by Rask!
His best of the game so far on Sharp. There's Char off the draw with a drive, and it's deflected, and Crawford kicks it out with his left pad. Minutes later, a quick transition and hard work along the boards put Boston back on its heels.
Taves crosses the Bruin line. Lucic trying to mug it down the right wing. Taves holds on the puck, got it to Kane right corner, put it in front of the net. Here's a shot by Oduya, save, rebound, score! Patrick Kane, Johnny on the spot on a rebound!
I think Patrick is very, very serious about his game.
The more exciting, the more emotional he gets, the better he gets as well. And that's not always true with most players.
Every big game, he seemed to shine even more.
You think there's a nothing play, he makes something out of it.
He's very relaxed with the puck, and he can make plays and see everything even in the heat of the moment.
You see the way he handles that puck and the way he creates space when he's holding it. He's unbelievable.
Patrick Kane has a certain something that's indefinable that every hockey player would love to have.
He's just one of those special players that just shows up for big games like that.
Bickle leads a 3-on-2 rush over the Bruin line. Left wing to Taves, back to Bickle, fires from a sharp angle, stops in front, he'll score! It's Patrick Kane with his second goal of the game! Found a juicy rebound at the top of the Boston crease, and with a backhanded flip, he put it in the top shelf. It's 2-0 off.
But while Kane shined, other stars weren't as lucky.
And we still haven't seen Patrice Bergeron.
He's not playing, and Carl Soderberg is on his line.
Come on, Carl. This is your time, bud. Yep. This is where you make your mark.
The Taves over the Bruin line down the right wing, cuts in front. Oh, and he's knocked down with a body check.
Obviously, I took a huge hit there late in the second, and tough coming back from that. Feeling a little shaken up, I guess you could say.
Taves got hammered and was slow to get to the bench.
And the second period comes to an end with the Blackhawks in game five, ahead 2-0.
Heading into the third, both teams' top forwards were a big question mark. Bergeron was sent to the hospital for evaluation, while Taves' condition still was unclear.
The coaches and the training staff did not think it was a good idea to let me go back on the ice for the third period.
It's tough losing our captain and a leader like that, but he stayed on the bench, he stayed positive.
I just felt calm and felt confident that we were gonna find a way to shut out the last 20 minutes.
So who's got to get it done for Boston to get back into this game?
Lucic on the right wing, backhands it in behind the net. Krejci behind the Chicago goal to Chara, drive, score!
That's a great shot.
Zdeno Chara rips it high glove on Crawford to cut the lead in half.
Relax out there, we're fine. Let's go, follow it up.
We have a game at 2-1.
With confidence growing, the Bruins desperately tried to tie the score.
Crawford makes the blocker save and then covers the puck with the glove and then gets steamrolled by one of the Bruin players.
Start here. Come on, buddy.
These confident fans are suddenly nervous.
Left side, Saad, towards the net, backhand and a saber ask.
And we're down to 2.5 remaining in regulation. Marshawn back the other way. Shot blocked, loose in front, save, rebound, oh! From a tough angle, Marshawn couldn't tuck it in and it's cleared back into the Boston end. What an opportunity there for number 63.
Krug shoved down by Frolik. Frolik over the line right side. Now to Bickle. Rush shot and a great save by Rask with a left pad.
Rask is on the bench. The Bruins go with six attackers and an empty net. The Blackhawks are 30 seconds away. Lucic tried to spin it around. Bowen took it away. He'll lift it to the line. And Krug is knocked down. Here's Bowen with a loose puck in center ice. He shoots. He scores! Empty net goal for Dave Bowen!
That was probably the biggest empty net goal I've ever seen in my career. We were pretty pumped at that moment.
Three games to two, the Hawks lead the Bruins. They'll play in game number six in Boston on Monday night.
Coming to you with a dog here.
Playoff games over 56 days. And tonight, for the first time, the Stanley Cup could be awarded.
We had a quick team meeting the night before, and some guys stepped up.
A lot of us reflected on our memories from 2010. We were in the same situation. We were up 3-2 going on the road.
Basically, the message was there's going to be a lot of excitement, a lot of nerves, but we just had to go out there and concentrate on the task at hand.
Good news for fans of both teams, Jonathan Taves of Chicago, Patrice Bergeron of Boston. Injury questions, but they will play.
You know, I cleared all the tests from the trainers and the doctors. There had to be a whole lot more than that to hold me back. Everyone's been on the grind for 2 months straight in the playoffs, and this is the first time that the Cup's on the line. You're not going to miss that chance.
Will the Hawks win the Cup tonight? We'll find out in a moment. The drop of the puck in center ice in game six is underway.
And the Bruins get physical right off the hop.
Late on the back. Seidberger shot geared away by Crawford.
Keep going. Do not let up. Center.
you got to tip your hat to Boston for the way they came out in that first period.
Lucic's shot that is held by Crawford.
Dickel is drilled center right by Payet.
Boychuk, top of the right circle. To Payet, right corner, put it in front of the net. Kelly kicks it on goal.
They threw everything at us to start the game.
Get Brock through, guys. Got to get him to the net, right?
Dumped out by Payet, sent to the front. Sagan sends it across. Score! Kelly makes it 1-0.
We were surprised and caught off guard that, wow, here they come.
Loads up. He shoots. What a save by Crawford on the tip.
Got the numbers. It's over to Peverly. To Krejci. Across to Lucic. Oh, and a shot blocked up high by Seabrook.
Our guys came up with some great plays defensively.
Ford, slow their guys up a little bit.
Shot and Dane stuck. Gave the puck away. And it got hit in the face for a shot by Thornton.
If I could just make a pass, it wouldn't have happened.
And the puck came up high on the head of Andrew Shaw.
I kind of turned the puck over and worked twice as hard to get it back, and
that was a scary moment for sure.
Oh, Shaw's it.
You see guys go off the ice and straight to the locker room, you knew it wasn't good.
He's a tough guy, and he's not going to stop with, getting a puck in his face.
With Shaw in the trainer's room, his teammates refocused.
No, let's go. Let's get a good feeling here.
But Boston continued to pressure.
What's the magic, baby?
Sagan leads it ahead. Marchand brought it in. Nice move to get free. Bennett front on. It was sent just wide. A wide open net.
And Krejci couldn't finish it.
Peverly hands it off far side. Gets it back. Peverly with a shot. And Crawford may have gotten a piece of that.
For a second there was kind of scary. They were almost invincible the way they were playing.
We were lucky to get out of there being down one goal.
They deservedly could have been up two or three.
Another drive, and the period has come to a close.
And this crowd at TD Garden rising to their feet in appreciation of the effort by the home team.
After that period, we had to be harder to play against. We had to be a little bit more responsive to the physicality of the game. And let's go.
Here's Andrew Shaw back in action for Chicago.
Kelly gets in there, and we're going to have one penalty here. I believe it's only going to be Shaw.
I think so.
Big Joe, hey, come on.
We weren't panicking. We knew we were still in the game.
There's Taves over the Bruin line, down the right wing. He shoots. He scores!
Let's go.
Just as Shaw steps out of the penalty box, the captain ties the score.
Now we're back in it.
To get that two-on-one chance and get a big goal to tie up the game gave us that feeling that we could find a way to win.
Now we got our legs going. Let's play, hey? Let's play together here.
He's a leader.
Let's start shooting it, hey, White? Start shooting it here. Let's go.
You learn from experience on how to be the guy in charge and how to get the guys going, and Jonathan has a good feel for that.
Better. The puck's down low. Keep playing.
He leads by example. He says the right things, but he also goes out there and does them.
Let's communicate better on that. We can't just switch.
We are now halfway through regulation time.
Chicago has gotten better in this period.
Sharp at the top of the left circle, a drive, blocked in front, loose puck, and it's played away by Chara.
Sending it back along for the carry back on by Sharp. Drive, save, made by Rask.
Jonathan shoots, he missed the net with 23 seconds left.
And that's going to do it for this second period.
40 minutes played, 33 shots taken, 18-15 Bruins, and it's 1-1.
I remember talking to my dad in the intermission, and I just said, all we need to do is win one period now to win the cup.
We gotta make a push here, eh? Let's make a push here.
Let's go do it. This is where we step up.
Back checked away by Paye. Steps right back into Sagan. Sagan trying to fight by Paye in front. Oh, and what a save by Crawford.
Now Shaw sent it right in front. Stahlberg knocks it down. Seabrook with a chance and a save by Rask.
Bodies flying all over in anxious moments in front of the net.
Nearly turned over. Now it is. Krejci steals. Krejci turns. Wants to get it to the front. He does. Score! Milan Lucic has made it 2-1 Boston.
It's tough.
You know, we're battling hard and we're playing hard. And when you see that goal go in, your heart sort of stops. There's always some tough moments when you get scored on in an opposing building. And you know, you kind of get that sinking feeling in your stomach, and you just got to let it go and move on to the next shift and the next play.
Come on, White, respond, boys, respond here.
As a team and as a whole, we knew we had more.
And this crowd on their feet as the Bruins have gained a 2-1 lead, trying to force a game 7.
We had some great chances right after that and kept pressing and pressing to tie it up.
How will the Hawks respond now?
Stahlberg brings it on back. Shoots one. Oh, and a save by Rask.
Take it yourself.
Gloved down by Kane, trying to step around a defender. He does. Kane with a shot, and he lifted it too high.
Under 3 minutes to go.
Bad by shot has Sagan right with him. Tyler Sagan off the side of the post.
Under 2 minutes remaining in regulation. And now we will keep an eye on Crawford in that Chicago net.
Turned aside.
Six attackers on the ice for the Blackhawks. Trying to tie this up.
Keith on the left board. The chase beside the net. Put it in front. Nichols, did he score? Brian Bickle with a point-blank shot.
I don't think I've ever jumped that high.
This game is tied with 1:16 remaining in regulation.
The game's tied up. It's like, wow. How did that happen?
When you score a goal that late to tie the game, you're always pretty confident you're going to win it in overtime.
Bowley's line hasn't played in 5 or 6 minutes. We're going to go Bowley's line. We'll come back with Johnny's line again in the last 30. And then, you know, they're out there right off the bat, and it's like, okay. And all of a sudden, it's in their end.
Marcus Kruger back to the line. O'Doyle with a shot. They score! Bowley!
We didn't know if it was real. Like, did that just really happen?
2 goals in 17 seconds.
You saw his reaction, too. He looked pretty happy. He looked like he scored in overtime and the game was over.
It's like a yard sale. He loses both gloves and a stick.
My gloves got caught, actually. Once I slid my hands back, my gloves just came off, and there we go.
58 seconds away from the Stanley Cup are the Chicago Blackhawks.
This crowd is just in shock.
As high as our emotions were and how excited we were, we kind of had to settle down there and still finish off the game.
One more minute. All the guys on the bench are holding their breath the whole time. When I went down the ice and chipped the puck down in their zone, I looked up and saw there was 3 seconds left on the clock. Next thing you know, we're walking away with the Stanley Cup. It almost felt like we stole it.
For the second time in 4 seasons, the Chicago Blackhawks have won the Stanley Cup! The Blackhawks have snatched victory from the hands of defeat.
Turn of events that you rarely see in hockey or in any sport.
Way to step up big!
Oh my God.
You deserve more than any of us.
What happened?
That's the craziest thing I've ever seen.
We had to watch it on the plane afterwards to really comprehend what exactly happened.
You're the best, buddy. You're the best. That's a great series.
Congrats. All of a series.
It's an honor to play against you.
The team that began this season with the greatest start in NHL history gets the ultimate finish to any season.
Unreal, baby. Chicago.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
The pose, and now the raise.
Woo! Woo! Where's my boy, Zeus? There you go, big boy.
I didn't want to make him wait any longer to toast the cup.
I always imagine how we're going to lift it. So best thing that's going to happen to a hockey player.
Hanzus, Roosevelt, Jamal Mayers. Those guys, they've had long NHL careers and haven't had a chance to win one.
Go for a skate! Go for a skate!
It was the 35 lightest pounds I've ever lifted. To be honest with you, I didn't know I was going to get to do in my lifetime, just take a little lap with that thing over my head.
Bloody but unbowed and raising the cup, they are making a lot of memories right now.
You see yourself in pictures, and you got to take a step back and look and think, is that really me?
That's how you start off a career, ain't so? That's how you do it.
I feel like I'm going to pass off.
See you, Daddy.
Kiss and cough.
Mama, think cough.
Mama, think cough.
Just overnight, you have an amazing bond with your teammates that'll last a lifetime. Forget the moments on the ice and in the locker room, on the plane ride back to Chicago, and everything, you know, weeks after.
That's what it takes to win a Stanley Cup right there, my friend.
It all happens so fast, but a lot of great moments you'll never forget.
We got her.
Drop it, John.
Here we go.
Hi, guys. Look who's here.
Hey!
Not only for the Blackhawks organization, for them to be able to have the success that they have is significant in the Chicago sports landscape, but in the National Hockey League.
Well, the city of Chicago, by and large, has been championship starved in a lot of areas, and there is a great appreciation and satisfaction knowing that any of us who had a small part behind the scenes in bringing a championship to the fans of Chicago, to the entire city of Chicago, has great meaning.
It's a validation, and I think it further cements this incredible alliance between our fans and the players and the coaches. We're seeing a young demographic really blossom and embrace this franchise. And, we said in 2007, for all of you Blackhawk fans that are out there, it's time to come back. You're going to be very proud of the direction that we're headed.
You can't go around town or in the suburbs without seeing these Blackhawk license plates, these Blackhawk flags streaming from the tops of cars. It's 90 degrees and people are wearing Blackhawk long sleeve sweaters to the grocery store. It's incredible. I've never seen anything like it, and I've seen a lot of hockey in Chicago. It's never been like this.
There's a saying I said throughout the playoffs that represents this team perfectly. That's hockey, baby! I got a little present here. It's a trophy we give out after every game. The belt. I think it should go to the best player in the playoffs, number 50, Corey Crawford. For the guys that were here in 2010, we didn't think there was a chance that we could outmatch that performance by the fans, but you guys did it somehow. This shows how unbelievable this city is. Unbelievable, thank you.
Smile. It's gonna feel good, boys. It's gonna feel good.
Get all over them. No room for them out there. Let's go.
Nice. Here we go, boys. Come on.
No panic in our game here, boys. No panic here.
All right, boys. We're all right.
Let's make our push.
We gotta get in there right away. Right away, boys.
I got the mic on. I was gonna give it to him.
Where's that? Where'd they find the aquarium to fit your head?
Try me. I'll drop them right now.
I'm more valuable than you.
Oh, yeah.
You're the last person I'm scared of out here.
You're not scary.
Kunitz's been telling me to flash my teeth. He's trying to get me twice now already.
I only got one left, so.
Don't slash any or hook anyone or cross-check anyone or punch anyone.
Are you yelling at me?
We're cheering for your fourth.
It's coming, Jimmy.
Your side. Hey, right here, Shell.
That's a good play. Spread it out. Behind the net.
Go C to D or whatever it went. Yeah. I'm coming to get back on top of the third guy.
The play is to me, and then I shift the weak side.
Yeah.
I'm open there.
You got anything in the slot here, I'm going to spread out. You're coming over up top.
If you got me in the middle, send it to my chest. If you don't, I'll catch
look
it.
Look for me blowing the zone, like off these boards.
Be just between the hash marks.
Yeah, right in the middle.
Yeah!
Head away, Taylor!
Hey, boys!
That's it!
You got me in front, Pav, eh?
Set up as a D1 timer or a bossy. I'm coming from the wall.
I might drag it, put it here.
We're probably gonna try to shoot a lot here.
One timer, Lubo?
One timer here. Come with me over here, though.
Hey, watch the shot right here, Sutter. I got this guy.
Stay with him. Let me take nine.
Loose. Pull. Two. Pull. Yeah! Woo!
That worked, I guess.
That was dirty.
What a play, Sacco.
Good play.
Oh, my God, that is hockey.
Showtime! Yeah!
I thought Phillip was going to go
backhand. Jeez.
I got a good feeling about you, Loopy.
More shots, boys. More shots here. Let's go.
We will. Shoot it. Shoot it.
Yeah! Great job, guys.
Yeah!
Good luck, Harris.
Good luck, Harris.
Good luck, buddy.
Good luck, man. Thanks, man.
But that's a good job. You deserve it.
Woo! Okay.
Yeah,
boy. Come on, boys.
I'm going to give this to Mr. Brassard. Oh, oh, oh.
Great effort tonight, boys. Hank, great game, buddy.
Well, 18 years in the league, and this is one of the sweetest moments I've had, I think. Great job from everybody. We don't make it pretty. But we work for each other, and we got some great goaltending again.
Hip hip!
Hooray! 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 Hooray!
Go, Nemo! Big night, baby!
Let's go! Let's go!
Bombs away!
First goal guard!
That's a start right there.
Good start, boys. Good start. Go at him here.
Gotta jump. Gotta go. Gotta go. Gotta go.
Hey, let's have a shift here, hey, boys.
Get ready right off the hop.
I'm going to go right to the blue, right to the corner blue. You think you can give it to me?
Watch out for that guy. Right wing.
Against you, just shoot. All right, go front. Help him. You got right.
Let him stick.
Heads, one coming.
And down.
Hit him. Boom. Let's see how tough you are. Captain Hero.
You got a problem? No, let's go. That's it. Let's go then.
Say the word, buddy.
You're on a new show, 4-4.
That's the play. That's the play. Here we go.
That's fine, boys. Let's get one here.
Yeah! Yeah! Yes! Yes! Yes!
Let's get another one. Let's get another one.
Yes. 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 Yeah!
Good job, everybody.
That's a great shot. Way to pick that corner.
Jesus Christ.
If you swing this way, if he chips it, you gotta get there faster.
Yeah.
I gotta come around the other side. And then we need to have something.
Oh.
Sorry, Toots.
Sorry.
Slide right a bit. Good.
Tough edge.
Hurt a little bit.
You'll hear my voice.
Melon!
I'll be a lot louder.
It's a hard toe drag to pull off. Especially when you can't toe drag.
That's a sick backhand. Way to go on one up us, Sid.
Guy loves playoffs.
Who we got?
Pavs and Boiler.
I got stuff.
That's a hammer.
Attaboy, Dougie. Your puck, Gunn. Your puck.
Attaboy, Lou. Attaboy. Hands down. Attaboy.
Howie.
Good job. Drew's nice play.
Rosie.
Go, Johnny. Go, Johnny.
What's that, David Krejci?
All right, Luke, right now.
Let's feed off a kill, boys. Feed it off. Come on now. Here we
what
go.
Do, what do you want to do?
They're playing that slot, man. So. We go to the knees, wide open shots.
Smacking it back in, boys.
Oh, spin off of them.
Look at that play, boys, be aware.
Watch out, weak side, he's open, boys.
Nice play, boys.
Power play.
Oh.
Come on, boys, Dave, get him back here, come on.
Nice reels, old boy. Nice play, boys.
Yeah!
OT, game seven.
OT, hey, attaboy.
Good, two.
Good luck. What a game, boys. A lot of guys stepped up. Chris Kreider, the legend grows.
Great effort, guys. A lot of unselfish plays out there, and keep it going that way. It's been a lot of fun.
I will eat the puck if I have to.
Hey, do our job.
Hey. Hit him!
Attaboy, Cliff, attaboy. Okay, should I go into the middle there, eh?
And the tempers are simmering.
Yeah, they're marching.
What do you want?
What are we doing?
Whatever you guys think.
As you see me come up, just back away this way.
Get to that net.
Easy enough.
Okay, you go middle, I go forward.
I stall and go to the net, I pop out here.
Yeah.
I see you, you see who went.
No, Johnny, get up high.
come right here.
Through here.
Come on, here we go. Big shift.
Hey, you think you can miss the net on purpose?
Hey, I got Keith.
Hey, what is this? Time out here? Let's go.
Drop it.
Hey, center, center.
Hey!
Go, go, guys, go.
Hey, hey! Find it.
Nice, your the puck's bouncing. But we can't have those excuses. Let's just chip it, use our speed, get to the net.
It's probably a good time to score.
Fires a shot, stop the referee, let's score! Looks like he swatted it through his own legs and passed Jonathan Quick.
Next to Gregory, he put it in his own net.
He did it?
Yeah.
Was it you?
Well, I touched it, but he just put it in his own net afterwards.
Moves it to Bickle, over the King line, high slot, shoots, he scores! Brian Bickle with his third goal in three games against the Kings in this playoff.
You're hot, you're hot.
Horton, wrist shot, and score! Horton put it in. Horton from the left wing circle.
Hey, good job on the support there, eh? We're rolling, we're rolling.
Come on.
It's stick always great, right?
Drop pass. They go left side and a quick shot by Krejci, score again.
Hey, Luke.
Play.
So happy to you do that?
Hey, great job.
Case has it. 2-on-1 break for the win. Over the King line, left wing to Katie, scores! The Hawks are going to the Stanley Cup final!
How are you?
All good, bud.
All right. Good luck. Very serious.
Good job, Hawks. Good luck, man.
There will be a new Stanley Cup champion.
Did you see that coming or what?
Oh my God.
No, there's no pain in this body at all. You know, a lot more was hurt in my face before the game, but you know, this win, you know, healed it all.
Unbelievable. Best feeling in the world.
Amazing. My third time in the finals and first time getting a hoisted, so it's awesome. Felt like it had hand grips in there, you know, I felt like it was meant to be.
You guys want to take the picture? You guys ready for this?
Yeah, but all our fans are over there. Let's get them in the back. We got everybody?
Yeah, save the bar! Save the bar! Woo! Yeah, baby!
You know, I think it's going to be just party right now, and I can't wait for it.
No, we're giving it to you, but we're going to keep it so it doesn't get stolen. So give me your jersey.
It's way better than losing.
Redfield Doctor.
Best player in the NHL, right there.
Load in the face, the brute.
There he is.
Thank you.